upon arrival, but I have the situation well in...
I have no interest in your failures, Commander. I am here on a mission of my own.
Hey guys, Alan here, and we're playing some Star Wars The Force Unleashed. It's the first game, obviously, and I will be doing a walkthrough of the second. Now, it'll take me a while to get used to the controls. I haven't played this game in a while, so I'm trying to figure out what to do. So I know how to block. X is to attack. Don't know what Y does. I guess it's force attack. Or not. The reason I wanted to play this game was I'm reading the Star Wars book, The Force Unleashed, which I recommend to anyone, actually. How awesome does that look? But yeah, also, you know, usually I don't add commentary to walkthroughs that I do, and that's mainly because it's really hard to focus entirely on playing the game and doing a good job of it, while at the same time making the commentary that's, you know, fun to listen to. And I just wanted to give it a go because I want to get better, obviously, at doing this, and the only way to do that is practice, I guess. So I guess you could look at this as a kind of trial run in a way, to see how it turns out, you know? Oh, okay. Just having a little mess with the controls. This is the tutorial level, so that's all good. I don't like playing as Darth Vader because he's really slow. But yeah, the other two reasons that I don't really add commentaries to games is simply I usually don't like it because it interrupts with the game. Like, most people want to watch a walkthrough, but they don't want to hear people talking. And that's one reason that, you know, I don't want to. Sorry, my mom came in, so I couldn't really talk there. But I just couldn't. The reasons are, like, simply that people want to watch for the story, you know, and I figured talking over that might kind of ruin their viewing of the game, but at the same time, it probably is what keeps people interested, you know. Over longer games, you know, like, some games might last 20, 30 minutes, and no one's going to watch that much of gameplay, especially parts when you're just walking around, you know. So that's why I figure I might as well add some commentary and hope for the best. and like I said, I think that's the only really two reasons I can think of. There was another one, but I can't really remember it. Let's have some fun with this guy. The graphics are actually pretty good for this game, considering it came out, like, I don't know when, like, nearly 2 years ago, I think it is, at this stage. So I'm pretty happy with that. Let's see what I can do. Aha! Always looks good. Okay, there my guys. Oh, it's just, Vader moves so slow. So that's what that button does. It's like, locks onto people. Here we go. like I was saying earlier, actually, I started reading the Star Wars Force Unleashed book, which is based actually on this game. Obviously, I'm pretty sure it was written after the game, but it puts the story in more detail and gives you a different perspective on how the game works. And I really think it's well worth reading if like you're into that kind of stuff. oh my god, he just like jumped there and fell off himself. Oh, that was stupid. But it's like really interesting because it gives like, it describes everything that happens in this game, obviously. So if you played the game, you don't need necessarily to read the book, but at the same time, it's just really interesting. Oh no, that didn't work. But it's just really interesting, and I really like it. It's really, ooh, didn't know what I did there. Sensitivity's a bit low. I might want to change that. Of 12. Cool. I'm happy with that. Okay. Okay. Now I have to find this Jedi that I want to kill. I really like messing around with the Force push and the Force grip. It's good fun. And lightsaber throw is probably my favourite offensive weapon because it does so much damage and it's a ranged attack, so it's pretty good. So,
Dark Lord! Whatever you want, you won't find it here!
Cannot disguise yourself from me, Jedi.
Turn back!
Guy seems pretty short for a powerful enemy. Oh. Ouch, that actually hurt. But no matter. These awesome fishing moves that they did. It looks really, really good.
Clouded your mind. You killed my master years ago.
Then now you will share his fate.
What's this?
A son.
Run! Lord Vader. Training is nearly complete. It is time to face your first true test.
Your spies have located a Jedi.
Yes, Master Ram Kota. He is attacking a critical Imperial shipyard. Destroy him and bring me his lightsaber.
I shall leave at once, Master.
The Emperor cannot discover you. Leave no witnesses. Kill everyone aboard, Imperials and Kota's men alike.
As you wish, my master.
Ah, master! Another excellent duel!
Proxy, you did catch me by surprise. I haven't fought that training program in years. I thought you'd erased it.
I hoped that using an older training module would catch you off guard and allow me to finally kill you. I'm sorry I failed you again.
I'm sure you'll keep trying. Yeah, but do me a favor. Don't ambush me anytime.
Proxy!
Yes, why were we whispering?
Shh, who's that?
Ah, yes. Your new pilot has finally arrived, Master. Accessing Imperial records.
Captain Juno Eclipse, born on Korolag, where she became the youngest student ever accepted into the Imperial Academy. Decorated combat pilot with over 100 combat missions, and commanding officer during the bombing of Kallus. Handpicked by Lord Vader to lead his Black 5 squadron, but later reassigned to a top secret mission.
Is there a psychological profile in there too?
Actually, yes. But it's restricted. I can tell you she's going to be impossible to reprogram.
Do you know why you're here?
Yes. My orders are clear. And keep your ship running and fly you wherever your missions require.
Did Vader tell you that he killed our last pilot?
No. But I can only assume that he gave Lord Vader good reason to do so. I will not.
Well, let's hope so. I'm sick of training new pilots. What have you done to my ship?
I've taken the liberty of upgrading the Rogue Shadow sensor array. Now you'll be able to spy on any suspect ships within the entire system. You are one of Vader's spies.
You don't need to know anything about my missions except where I'm going. Now I need to jump to Nar Shaddaa. Can you handle that?
Of course.
So that's the first mission complete and the tutorial. I guess I'll,
Welcome aboard the Rogue Shadow, Master. Griff is one of your core forces. Excellent. Similarly, move the
I guess I have to go through this tutorial as well before I leave.
Good. Note that you cannot move while concentrating in this manner. Now use the right stick to move the object up, down. Excellent, Master. Now, prove your mastery of grip by using the object to smash through these three glass panels.
Guys, I'm gonna leave the commentary here, and I'll talk to you guys
Excellent,
later.
Excellent, Master. You can also use grip to pick up and throw an object. Press and hold the grip button to grip an object. left stick in the direction you wish to throw, and release the grip. Now demonstrate your newfound power by gripping and throwing these objects to knock over the three frightened stormtroopers standing in front.